Backing up and restoring Zammad is very easy and trouble-free. Let me show you how that's done. I will explain the configuration options and how to backup automatically. This video is not for you if you are using a Docker-based installation. Helmshard and Compose versions automatically backup every 24 hours for you by default. Zammad comes with an example backup script that can be found within opt zammad contrib backup. If you've never used backup and restore of Zammad, you'll first have to rename or create a copy of the configuration file. To do so, change into the backup directory and either use copy or move on config dist to have a new file called config. Now open the configuration file with any editor of your choice. Depending on your Zammad version, you'll find several settings to configure. Backup dir is the destination the backup and restore scripts writes new backups to or reads back a backup during a restoration. The default directory defined here does not exist by default and has to be created manually. If you want to make sure your machine can die without losing the backup, make sure to store this backup to another machine via NFS or whatever fits your use case. Old days defines how many days your backup files should stay in your backup directory. Keep in mind that the Zammad backup scripts create full dumps on every run. This may be an issue if you have limited storage available. Usually a hold time of something between 4 and 14 days should be fine. Full FS dump allows you to tell the backup script to only backup the database and storage directory of Zammad. If you want this, that is option 2 no. For compatibility reasons, the value of this setting by default backs up the complete opt Zammad directory. Only store the storage directory, especially if you plan to migrate to a new machine to reduce the workload on your end. This setting has been added with Zammad 5.1. You can use debug if you need further debug output. This provides informational outputs like detected settings. This option shouldn't be required during productive backups. After you show your initial configuration, you can run a manual backup of Zammad by executing opt zammad contrib backup zammad underscore backup sh. The backup process can be run either as root or Zammad user. Just make sure the affected user can at least read the Zammad directory and database and write to the backup storage. This will give you an idea how long the backup currently runs. Please note that if you don't stop your Zammad instance, the file storage and database may drift apart. This can cause inconsistency during a restore. If you're happy with the way your backup works, you can use a cron job to run the backup automatically. This allows you to run an automated backup outside of your business hours and optionally mount, unmount and restart Zammad if you'd like. This here is just an example. In this example, I'm using a permanently mounted NFS storage. This technically isn't the safest way and thus only serves demonstration purposes. One thing that drastically slows down Zammad's backup and restore processes are the attachments. These by default are stored in the database. This brings serious downsides like possibly degraded load speed due to database server load of binary files. And of course, the time required to dump the database. Database dumps containing binary data are always a lot bigger. That might be an issue. To overcome this, you can store these files in the server's file system. Note that this may be troublesome for Docker-based installations. Zammad allows you to store the attachments in any directory by using a symlink. This is supported by the backup script since the 3rd July 2023. If you want to use symlinks, make sure Zammad still uses the database for attachments. Change to the Zammad directory and run ln-s, the path of your choice, storage. Use whatever path fits your system. Now create and change the owner of the directory in question to Zammad. This path has to be available during Zammad runtime. Not doing so can cause data loss. Now change the attachment storage to file, either via web or console. The storage directory will automatically be created if you didn't provide a symlink. As a second step, move existing attachments to the file system by running store :: file move db file in the Rails console. This comment can safely be run during runtime, even in productive time. You can add a third parameter to the comment to pause copying in between files, for example 5 seconds. Normally, this shouldn't be necessary. So that's how to backup Zammad. Pretty easy, right? If this video helped, please consider leaving a subscription to this channel to not miss out any new upcoming videos. Until next time, take care.